Okay, so good afternoon, Balikas. No, I'm really sorry for the interruption. So, the first video was interrupted because, of course, due to my poor internet connection. So, this is just the second part of my lecture video. I will just continue. We are on slide 36. No, and we have 47 slides all in all. No, so hapit na ta. No, so hopefully, dili siya ma-interrupt until I end this video. And then, so that straight na lang, duhara ka part ang ato ang lecture for creative writing. Okay, so I will now share my screen with you. Okay, so as you can see, nag-convert pa ko sa USA, no? So I will just proceed. So last time, no, we have discussed, no, nga how vividly ang fish gi-describes sa poem ni Elizabeth Bishop. Nandugan siya gima-gima dito niya, isda radi ay. So, di ba he, or she actually described nga ancient, mag-ancient wallpaper na ang skin sa fish. No, meaning, the fish is really that old. No, because puno na siya o ka ng kuan. No, puno na siya o ka ng mga barnacles. No, puno na kayo siya o ka ng, ano, very kuan na kayang skin, no, mag-tattered. So in just few lines, no, Bishop mentions many colors including rose, white, green and brown. So pwede nimo ma picture out, no, nga the fish is could be multicolored, no, or the multicolored siya because of the barnacles that is hanging from his skin, no, or the sea lice nga naa sa iyang panit, no. That is why nga siya multicolored. Okay. So I'll give you an example again. This is a second example. So the first one was a poem. So this one is, I'm going to read the second example ha. Gayus Japon siya og imagery. So a taste for the miniature was one aspect of an orderly spirit. Another was a passion for secrets. In a prized varnish cabinet, a secret drawer was opened by pushing against the grain of a cleverly turned dovetail joint. And here she kept a diary, locked by a clasp, and a notebook written in a code of her own invention. An old tin petty cash box was hidden under a removable floorboard beneath her bed. So, no, gi-kanya, no, gayusog imagery sa pag-describe sa girl nga na siya passion for secrets because she kept things in secret drawers and in hidden floorboards, no, for people to discover siguro or siguro to hide from prying eyes. So okay, so this excerpt is from Ian McEwan's novel Atonement. We can almost feel the cabinet and its varnished texture, or the joint that is specifically in a dovetail shape. So he described, it's really heavy on tactile, no. Tactile yung gigamit ng imagery because it's more on the texture, no, of the furniture. We can also imagine the clasp detailing on the diary, clasp ka namurag lock sa diary, and the tin cash box that's hidden under a floorboard. Various items are described in depth so that the reader can easily visualize them. So, in a very short excerpt palang class, ma-imagine na ni mo nga daghan kay siya gipangtago sa iyang room, no, and may imagine na po ni mo sa mga furniture it can be found sa room, no, sa katong tao nga iyang gikuan or sa katong girl. Okay, so next, let's now proceed with imagery in pop culture. So katong duha ka excerpts class, no, katong sa poem and katong sa story is imagery in literature. So let's now proceed to imagery that are used in pop culture. So imagery can be found throughout pop culture in descriptive songs, colorful plays, and in exciting movie and television scenes. As what I've mentioned before, no, in scripts class, no, even in production sets, gamit heavy ka sila sa imagery, no, sa mga scripts, sa tanan mo maghimo gitag music video sa usa ka kanta or movie, no, or let's say kanang magkantog play. Gagamit mas lag script class, no, and then use mas lag heavy imagery para mas dali pud sa mga actors, no, or sa mga actresses nga mo imagine unsa ang setting, no, sa story or sa movie, no. Okay, so we will just watch. I don't know if makaya sa ako ang kuan internet. We'll try to watch Wes Anderson's Fantastic Mr. Fox on YouTube. If delete carry sa YouTube. But let's just pray makaya ra sa YouTube. Okay. Carry ra. Fantastic, Mr. Fox. Okay, I will just stop share for a while. Okay, so let's resume. Naka-open ako sa Fantastic Mr. Fox. I will just share my computer sound para madunggan ninyo.
And so it begins.
Welcome to the fantastic world of Mr. Fox.
Woo!
Should we dance?
His life is fantastic.
Pure wild animal craziness.
His wife is fantastic.
If what I think is happening, it better not be.
His neighbors, not so fantastic.
This is Bogus, Bunce, and Bean, three of the meanest, nastiest, ugliest farmers in his valley.
What was that?
They're digging us up.
But they're about to discover.
Oh, Foxy, is help on the way?
He's one fox.
I've got an idea.
You can't outfox.
Mole, what do you got?
I can see in the dark.
We can use that. Rabbit, I'm fast.
Badger,
demolitions expert.
What? Since when? Here, put these bandit hats on.
I don't have a bandit hat,
but I modified this tube sock.
We look good.
Yeah, we do.
The only security is an old hunting beagle. I laced some blueberries with sleeping powder. Beagles love blueberries.
A titanium card.
What's this thing you do, the whistle with the clicking sound?
That's my trademark.
We're different. We all are. Him especially. But there's something kind of fantastic about that, isn't there?
I can fight my own fight.
No, you can't.
I guess we should start doing something, right?
Let's see some hustle.
Yeah! Woo!
This fall, forget Super.
That was close, Rat. Be careful.
Oh, I'm as careful as I...
Ignore Incredible.
I can fit through there. You wanna know why?
Why?
Because I'm little.
It's all about Fantastic.
You really are fantastic.
I try.
Fantastic Mr. Fox.
What's this lightning bolt?
This fence might be electric.
Well, I just hope it doesn't mean thunder, because I have a phobia of that.
So that is Fantastic Mr. Fox. And so I will just minimize the screen. So Wes Anderson is known for his colorful, imaginative, and vivid movie making. The imagery in this film is filled with detail, action, and excitement. So not only that, Mr. Fox also describes his enemies, his not so fantastic neighbors in a very vivid nga imagery. So the writers, or let's say the people who made this movie actually made this from a book. So they were able to picture out what is Mr. Fox really like in a movie, because it was vivid kayo pagka describe sa book. So dali na lang kayo sila hanga, mooni siya ang life ni Mr. Fox if you're going to depict it in a movie, because dali na kayo siya i-describe kung kayo naanatanan sa libro. So mapun na siya. Okay? Next is What a Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong. So I will show you in another video.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds wash it white. The bright, blessed day, the dark, sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
So, diba, nagkadug naman mo sa lyrics, no? Sa What a Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong. So, masking wala pa tong video, maminaw pa lang mo daan sa song, na-describe na it's a perfect song, it's a perfect example of using imagery in the song. Kaya, for example, no? Emphasize niya ang red blooming roses, no? White clouds, blue skies, no? From bright day to dark night, from the smiles of people na passing by, nung katong bata nga ning dako siya. So, I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. So, kana palandaan, no, sa lyrics palandaan, gidescribe niya ang trees, ang roses, no? So, kanang I see the colors of the rainbow, no? So, kana, imagine po nimo ang colors of the rainbow, no? Because of course, nasa imagery nga gigamit sa kuan sa song. So, kaan na mo class, no? Ka-understand na mo nga, yung ano ka-importante ang imagery. So, maski naminaw na ka sa song ni Louis Armstrong, no, imuha lang na-imagine dayon nga, kan, mo ni yung gi-picture out nga imagery. Maski wala pa ka naglanto atong music video. So, di ba? No, so, again, no, if you're going to think about imagery, just go back to Louis Armstrong's song nga, What a Wonderful World. Okay. So, sa proceed to related terms, you have metaphor, which is a part of figures of speech, no? So, you have simile, metaphor, hyperbole, no? Alliteration, daghan personification, no? So, daghan na, assonance, daghan kasi lang ang klase nga figures of speech, no? That was actually found on your module, no? So, naana na sa ako, if you're going to recall or have a refresher on your figures of speech, naana siya sa inyong module 2, no? Nga akong gi-upload sa Google Classroom. So, metaphor is often used as a type of imagery. Specifically, metaphor is a direct comparison of two distinct things. Here is an example of metaphor as an imagery. Her face, her smiling face is the sun. So, face and the sun are not the same class, no? Pero they are compared with each other. So, meaning, if you're just going to imagine, probably bright ka ihang face, no? Just like the sun ka bright because she is smiling. Or, I'll give you an example. His temper was a hurricane whipping through the school, scaring and amazing his classmates. So, gihalin tulad ang yung temper sa hurricane. So, meaning, imagine na kaakuan guro kaayo kanang gisapot guro siya, no? Or, grabe yung guro kaayo yung temper. Okay. Mag-charge ako. Okay, next. We were penguins standing in our black and white coats in bitter cold. So, we were penguins standing in our black and white coats. So, meaning, ayang gihalin tulad, maraming mga penguin, no, kay ga-coat mi og black and white, and then ga-kurog pa siya din sa bitter cold, no. So, probably, mga imagine nga, kanang nasa sa gawas, no, and it was snowing. So we have onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia is another figures of speech class, no? So onomatopoeia is also a common tool used for imagery. Onomatopoeia is a form of auditory imagery in which the word used sounds like the thing it describes. Here is a few examples of onomatopoeia as imagery. So the fire crackled and popped. No, so magiyahang gi ko ay gi-describe ang sound sa fire, no? Nga mo crackle man jud ang fire, no, ay mo pop man na siya usahay. Okay, so next, she rudely slurped and gulped down her soup. So mas kay siya mo inom, no, yung ana siya siyang soup. So ko ay no, so ano ba example? That's an example of onomatopoeia. You're describing the sounds of a thing, no? Magamit kag auditory imagery. Or for example, the pigs happily oinked when the farmer gave them their slop to eat. Let's now proceed to personification. So personification is another tool used for imagery. Personification provides animals and objects with human-like characteristics. Mga inanimate objects class, nga masking wala tani sila human emotions or mga human actions, pero gitagaan nimo sila human-like emotions or characteristics. O for example, no, ninghilak ako ang kuan, ninghilak akong tanom, kaya ako siyang gibiyaan, no, mga ingan. So here's a few examples of personification as imagery. So the wind whistled and hissed through the stormy night. So mo whistle din ang wind. So dili biya, no? So mo na siya. So gitagaan niya og kanang human-like characteristics. Or for example, the tired tree's branches moaned in the gust of the wind. Oh, so mukuan din na ang tree, kapuyon din na. May mo din ang kapuy ko, no? So the ocean waves slapped the shore and whispered in a fizz and they withdrew again. So makaslap din ang ocean. No, gislap niya ang dolomite sand sa Manila Bay. Dili biya na siya. Wala biya na siya human-like characteristics. But you can give them human-like characteristics in writing if you're going to use personification. So mura na siya class. Actually, daghan pa dyan na siya, no? Pero nahot na natag time. You can reread your module 2 again. Everything is already there. There are also examples, no? So thank you so much for listening, students. So stop share sa ako. Thank you, everyone. Goodbye. I hope nga mulang to may second part sa akong video. Goodbye, everyone.